I love engineering, and I just want engineering to be open to everyone. My mom is this fantastic leader, and I grew up in a world where I didn't realize that being female meant that I couldn't do things or I wasn't expected to do things. I thought if anything, my gender was an advantage. And getting into engineering in first year and looking around and seeing how few women were around me was a shock. But I'd been given the strength and the confidence to succeed and excel at this program, and I want every single girl to have that same opportunity. Engineering is a profession and it's technical, but it's also a really tight-knit industry because what we're doing is we're solving problems to serve society better. So we need to understand our society and what we're trying to do. I've run into these roles by accident. I just saw a problem and I saw some cool people and I've ended up being a leader, but it's added that well-rounded aspects to my degree that have been invaluable.
She's at the forefront of students in engineering, so she is a clear leader, a leader amongst leaders. She's somebody who communicates easily with a wide range of people, again, all the way from the president of UBC down to individual students.
My best and probably my last role with the Engineering Undergraduate Society was being president. It was a pivotal year for us. We conducted the EUS Inclusion Project. We created the Iron Pin Ceremony, and we rewrote 200 pages of policy. And it was a fantastic year because I had this passionate and inspiring team behind me. And we got to reimagine and be creative and do great things because the faculty supported us and our students supported us. And that's why we're sitting in beautiful buildings today with new events that we run every year. And looking back, it was one of the best years.
She's the type of person who's had a great influence here in engineering. She's changed things, whether it be like our volunteer structure, to our executive structure, to how we consider what we prioritize within our events and services. But she's also done the same thing at the Alma Mater Society, our student society on campus. She's done the same thing at the Board of Governors, and she brings that perspective of reaching all of the voices of students whenever she governs an organization.
The Canadian Federation of Engineering Students is an invaluable organization. They bring together people so that we can talk about what we're doing, share ideas, advocate for things. But they also run important conferences, like the Conference on Diversity in Engineering, which I ran in 2013, back when it was called the National Conference on Women in Engineering. And out of that came a conversation about diversity and inclusivity, especially that task force, where it was realized that we needed to relook at what the CFES was doing and have a national conversation about inclusivity in engineering. Universities are changing. We have the rise of the internet, and universities are no longer the keepers of knowledge, but I like to say the playgrounds of knowledge. And the value of a university degree is changing, but it's about importance that students get such a positive learning experience about life when they go through that. And that relays into a lot of things, whether it's your profs being engaged and passionate, or your peers being able to work with you in group projects, or your ability to get leadership roles. All of those things contribute to creating valuable individuals who will contribute to a better society.
Veronica Knott is one in a million, and I really think that that has to do with how selfless she is. The amount of power and responsibility that she has had in her roles over the years as a student leader on campus have been very immense. And always, 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 Veronica is putting the community before herself.
I like to live in the present in the sense that I keep all my options open. I don't know where I'm going to end up or what I'm going to do, but I always want to take the most exciting and newest opportunity out there.
I've told Veronica I could see her as being a prime minister one day. There's no limit to what she could potentially become with the sort of skills that she has.